In this screencast, we'll discuss the concept of sensors and transmitters and how it relates to the machinery in order to control a process. The sensors and transmitters represents the beginning of the step of control because it acts as the measurement step. The sensor measures the process variable, and it does this by a variety of different means, many of which are electrical or mechanical, to measure either the process variable or a related variable. We'll talk more about this distinction shortly. However, a controller will not be necessarily able to pick up that signal or understand the signal that the sensor gives. So therefore, that is what the role of the transmitter does. The transmitter converts the signal from the sensor into a value that the controller can understand. Generally, an electrical signal such as in milliamps or something defined as percent transmitter output. Oftentimes, the sensor and transmitter are coupled very closely together, such that they are often treated and defined and discussed interchangeably. So oftentimes in textbooks or other places, you'll see sensor, transmitter, or sensor transmitter, and oftentimes it's used to represent the combination of the two. This tying in together for a sensor and transmitter is oftentimes seen in the block diagrams for processes which involve some sort of control. In the block diagram we have here, the sensor is represented by the block circled. So this would represent the sensor and the transmitter. Oftentimes the block is represented as the transmitter block, sensor block, and the sensor transmitter block. Again, important point to note here is the fact that these are often interchangeable. So the value that comes into the sensor transmitter block is the value of whatever variable you're trying to control. And this could be in a wide variety of units, depending if it's a temperature, a pressure, a flow rate, a composition, etc. And what comes out after the sensor senses the value of the variable, and then the transmitter converts it into an appropriate signal, what will then come out is some sort of signal, which is a representation of that control variable measurement, oftentimes in milliamps or percent transmitter output. So a few points to note about the sensor transmitter block is that from a block diagram algebra standpoint, it is often zero order. However, it can sometimes be first order depending on the type of sensor transmitter you have. Many, particularly those which measure temperature and flow, will happen very close to instantaneously, so therefore they will be zeroth order. However, in some cases, such as composition, for example, they can potentially be first order. Another point to note is the fact that dead time can occur for a sensor transmitter system, and whether it be a zeroth or a first order process. The reason why is the fact that oftentimes values are measured downstream from the system, potentially in a long transportation line. So therefore, there could be a lag in terms of when the variable is actually measured. Another example of a situation with a dead time, aka transportation lag, or time lag, would be a system where you are measuring your value offline. For example, many composition sensors, such as GCs and the like, are not built into the system, so therefore there would be some dead time necessary in order to carry out that experimentation. In the table here, we have provided a list of different types of sensors. This is definitely not a full list. There are a whole host of types of sensors for the different variables that we have here: temperature, pressure, flow rate, level, composition, viscosity, and pH. The point what we want to talk about here is to go, when we talked about the definition of the sensor, we talked about the measurement of either the process variable of interest or a related variable. So this represents the difference between direct and indirect sensors. So the two types of sensors that we have are direct sensors, which measure the variable of interest, and indirect sensors, which find the value of your variable of interest by measuring another variable. Some examples of direct sensors would be thermometers. A couple examples of indirect sensors are many flow sensors act as indirect sensors, such as venturi meters and orifice meters, because what they're doing is we want the flow rate, but what they actually measure, by taking advantage of Bernoulli's principle, they can measure the pressure drop between two particular points and use Bernoulli's equation to find the flow rate. Another example of this would be to measure composition for distillation, for example, particularly if it's binary distillation. By knowing the temperature of your solution, you can use thermodynamic equilibrium, TXY charts, to determine what your composition is at a given pressure. So therefore, you could also need pressure as well in order to determine a composition. There are also a few important pieces of terminology that we'll see when we're talking about sensors. The range represents low to high for the value of interest. So in other words, your sensor reads from 50 to 250 PSI, or from negative 50 to 100 degrees Celsius. Another value of interest is the zero. The zero represents the lowest value that can be measured by the sensor. So in some cases, particularly measuring flow, the zero will be zero. But in many other situations, the zero of the sensor will in fact not be zero. So if I look at the two examples that I provided above with the pressure range and the temperature range, what we see is the fact that the zero is 50 psi for the pressure sensor and negative 50 degrees Celsius for the temperature sensor. The span represents the magnitude of the high value minus the low value. So in the case of what we have here, with going from 50 to 250 psi, the span would be 200 psi. And for the temperature sensor going from negative 50 to 100 degrees Celsius, this would be a span of 150 degrees Celsius. So in this screencast, we have provided a brief discussion on sensors and some relevant terminology about both sensors and transmitters.